Greetings builders and welcome back to another best build selection. This is the video where I bring 3 selected builds from a specific topic, and today's theme is corrosive and devastating. I'm of course talking about the chaos builds. And if you decide to make any of those, you can find links for the POB and complete guide in the video description. Let's start this video with a classic chaos build that is great for beginners. I'm talking about the Essence Drain Occultist with the Witch class. Essence Drain is a skill that drains the life of your enemies and even restores your life by a percentage of the damage dealt. Since it can only be used in one enemy at a time, we also use Contagion to spread the damage, resulting in an amazing increase in career speed. To hit the pros of this build, I would start with how easy it is to play. You just need to cast Contagion and Essence Drain to watch the whole screen of enemies melting before your eyes. This character is also very easy to put together because it doesn't need any mandatory unique item, and above all of that, it's very safe with many defensive layers. Now to list the cons, the first thing that comes to my mind is the boss damage. Even though this is a very cheap build, you need to invest several divine orbs to have a big single target damage. But don't worry too much about that, this build is meant as a red map farmer and it kills map bosses easily even on a low budget. As for budget, this build is very cheap, you can get it destroying early endgame maps with only around 35 chaos. To comfort for advanced to yellow maps, you need to invest around 100 chaos, and for easily completing your atlas, I recommend investing around 4 divines, but you can totally do it with less. Don't forget that on poebuilds.net you can find a list with all the equipments that you need to buy for this build, with direct links for examples being sold by other players. For clear speed, I'll give this build 10 out of 10. When you get a big area of effect in your Contagion, you kill enemies way beyond your sight with only one cast. The boss damage on the other hand is a 7 out of 10. It will take longer than usual to kill guardians and pinnacle bosses, but you have no problem against regular map bosses. For the survivability, I'll give it 9 out of 10. This build comes with over 100,000 effective HP because of high armor, high evasion, spell suppression, amazing life regeneration, and even a little bit of block chance. Next, we have one for the minion lovers out there, the Poison Raging Spirits Guardian with the Templar class. This build takes advantage of the high number of Raging Spirits you can summon to stack an absurd amount of poison on our enemies. To list the pros of this build, I would start with its boss damage. Once the build is complete, you are going to kill even the biggest bosses in just a few seconds. The survivability is also amazing. Since we can have all the defensive layers of a guardian on a minion build, that is already very safe to play. Now to list the cons, I would start saying that this build isn't for everyone. You need a lot of currency to put it together. Another issue is that Raging Spirits have a short duration and you have to often stop to resummon them. As for budget, this build would need at least 10 divine orbs to put together. As I said, it's an expensive one. You need 4 mandatory unique items for this build. The first one is the Uniting Drain Sword that grants an envy aura for a big amount of chaos damage to our minions. It also grants them 60% chance to poison on hit. We also need the Darkness in Front Bell that has 2 Abyss Jewel sockets for us to achieve 100% chance to poison our minions. Next, we need a Covenant Armor that grants our Raging Spirits a level 29 added chaos damage support. This means a lot more chaos damage. Finally, we also need the Ancient Skull Helmet that grants a healed damage and attack speed boost to our minions. For clear speed, I'll give it 9 out of 10. Even though we have many fast minions that destroy everything in seconds, they have a short duration and need to be resummoned often. That's the reason why I took 1 point out. The boss damage deserves 10 out of 10. You easily end up with over 30 million DPS, that's more than enough to decimate every boss in the game. For the survivability, I'll give it 10 out of 10. As a minion build, you already stay far from danger, but with this one, you also count with the many defensive layers from the Guardian Ascendancy. This grants over 100,000 effective HP. Finally, we have another awesome build for beginners, the Toxic Rain Raider with the Ranger class. This build uses all the attack speed of Raider to deploy numerous pods that drain the life out of your enemies. To list the pros of this build, I would start with how easy this build is to put together. You don't need any mandatory unique item and the leveling is very simple. This build is great for beginners because you end up having great clear speed, boss damage and survivability with low investment. Now to list the cons, the main issue of this build is mana. Since we're dealing with a damage over time build, we cannot reach mana or life. Because of that issue, we need rare rings that reduce the mana cost of skills. As for budget, you can get it destroying early endgame maps with only around 100 chaos. To comfort for advanced 2 yellow maps, you need to invest around 150 chaos, and for easily completing your atlas, I recommend investing around 4 divines, but you can totally do it with less. For clear speed, this build gets 9 out of 10. As a raider, you already have a lot of movement and attack speed. Also, you only need to deploy the pods once and they will drain surrounding enemies, granting a smooth gameplay. The boss damage also gets 9 out of 10. Combining your strength with toxic rain totems, bosses just drown in countless pods. Even the biggest ones are going to melt like butter before your eyes. For the survivability, I'll give it 9 out of 10. This is because this build has high evasion, high armor and spell suppression. Above all, you can use Toxic Rain from a safe distance and its pods heavily slow down enemies. And that's it guys, what did you think about those amazing Chaos builds? Please take a second to tell me in the comments and leave a thumbs up to support the channel. I wish you guys an amazing day and don't forget to keep building!